of Studies by Francis Bacon. Francis Bacon. Francis Bacon, also known as Lord Verulam, was born on January 22, 1561 at York House near the Strand in London. English poet and philosopher, served as Attorney General and Lord Chancellor of England. He is called as the father of empiricism. Educated at home in his early years and later received tuition from John Walsall and then moved to University of Cambridge. His first collection of essays was published in 1597. He is known as the father of the scientific method for publishing the Novum Organum Scientiarum, the new instrument of science, in 1620. He is considered as the father of English essays. He died of pneumonia on April 9, 1626. Of Studies. Published in the essay collection, Essays or Counsels, Civil and Moral. Indicates the value of knowledge in practical terms. Essay is direct and pointed. Details the use of studies for a Renaissance gentleman. Formal essay which builds up a serious tone which caters to the mind. Used parallel sentence structure to emphasize straightforward assertiveness. Summary. The writer opens the essay by stating that studies serve for delight, ornament, and for ability. People gather knowledge for delight as they enjoy it. People gather knowledge for ornament as they want to prove themselves in the eyes of others. People gather knowledge for ability as they want to show that they are able to do something. Spending much time to study will make a man lazy. Using wisdom to analyze very deep on a particular thing will make a man appear pretentious and arrogant. A person with huge knowledge and sticking to rules may invite hate from others. A person's natural ability is enhanced by studies, but without experience he may not be able to deal the outside world. A good moderation is necessary in making knowledge with experience. People who are deceitful will condemn studies as they accomplish their objectives through many crooked ways. Simple men will respect and value the studies. Wise men will use the studies to deal with the outside world. Reading is not to just accept the ideas of a writer, but to analyze the fact and act wise in all activities, as books are of varying content. Some books must be read for entertainment, some books are read to accumulate certain ideas, and some must be read slowly and minutely so as to truly fathom the meaning and essential sense. Some books can be sorted and the gist can be known from others. Bacon writes the famous statement, "Reading maketh a full man, conference a ready man, and writing an exact man." Reading a book, discussing with others, and writing will make a man to remove the residual weaknesses and ignorance from a person. Only through reading a man can attain wit. Studying history makes a man wiser, poetry makes a man writer, mathematics makes a man give logical sense, and philosophy makes a man to impart valuable lessons on morality. God has given wit to all humans, but it can be sharpened only by studying, as a body is kept fit by having physical exercise. If a man is not able to concentrate, let him learn mathematics, because he must be very keen to do the mathematics without error. By practicing so, he restrains the mind from darting off elsewhere. If a man is not able to distinguish, he may study Schulman so that he can train the mental ability and can develop the art of expression. If a man is not able to identify facts, he may study law so that he will be able to put his views convincingly in the appropriate places. Thus every deficiency of the mind can be cleared by the constant studying of the different areas which is essentially required. Thus Bacon indicates that study brings us joy and enhances our thinking, speaking and writing ability, and will fulfill every deficit of the human mind to lead a fruitful life. For more videos, like, share, subscribe. Thank you.